Hello everyone, welcome back to my another video. So today I would like to share with you my development of obstacle avoidance using this DJI Tello and also YOLOv4 machine learning framework. So I've seen plenty of video in the YouTube where a drone being taken down by a bird or crashed into some other things when flying. So I find it interesting for me to implement such a brief or simple obstacle avoidance in this Tello, but not to avoid a bird, because first I need to train huge number data set of birds, because birds come with many species. More importantly, it will be difficult for me to run an experiment with a living object. So instead, I change my avoidant object using this ball. So this ball has been trained using YOLOv4 machine learning framework, so that this Tello, when see it, able to know this is the obstacle that it need to be avoided, and when in some certain condition, this Tello will able to avoid it. For now, I'm using an official SDK from DJI and RISE for this Tello that sent through UDP communication. But it kept and limit our speed, this Tello speed, from 10 meter per second up to 1 meter per second, which is not very useful when you want to avoid object at high speed. So I need to extend the SDK using an unofficial one that developed by TelloPy and also the GoBot project using this Tello, that sending not using actual SDK but simulating or mocking what data being sent using the official Tello phone apps. So here's the thing that work need to be done. First of all, this ball need to be trained using YOLOv4 machine learning framework. Second, I need to extend my SDK to be for Tello to be able to move at speed 10 meters per second and more. And third, I need to implement my obstacle avoidance routine process. So that said, let's go back to the big picture and let me explain to you my top overview of how the component works. Okay, here we go. So this is my previous work on the path planning GUI. This is state machine. Then I change it to here. This is the one that reflect the originality what being implemented in the current code. As you can see here, I added the object ball for example to enter obstacle avoidance routines. And this state machine here is written in Python, getting output from the machine learning framework, which is YOLO, and the control system doing some control system stuff, and also does some logging. This is the SDK that I'm being extended that able to be compatible with the official app and also unofficial SDK. And this is communicating with DJI Tello using UDP communication. So here is the obstacle avoidance flow, simple flow diagram. So after image processing state, we will identify the ball speed, the distance, and also the time to collision. The time to collision I will explain to you later, but when the time to collision is less than 2 seconds, it will enter the obstacle avoidance, then return back to idle, then idle will identify which mode is we currently on and doing some other image processing and continuously in the loop. So what is time to collision? Let me explain to you. So the time to collision is, as the name suggests, the time for two objects to be collided. For example, this the ball and also Tello. What is the time to collision between this ball and Tello? We can identify using the relative speed between these two objects and also the distance between it at that time. So the formula is simple. Time to collision is equal to 1 over relative speed times with distance. The relative speed here means, for example, if this ball is moving at 2 meters per second and if this Tello is moving at 0 meter per second, then the relative speed is 2 meter per second. However, if this ball is moving at 2 meter per second and this Tello is moving also in 2 meter per second, the relative speed is 0 meter per second, which the time to collision will never happen. So for this example, I put the relative speed here is 2 meter per second and the distance when I detect the speed is 2 meter per second is 2 meters. So the time to collision that I estimate is 1 over 2 meter per second times with 2. So the TTC is 1 seconds. So if we follow this flowchart, we'll know that this will enter the obstacle avoidance routine when this scenario happens. So in addition, To know that my obstacle avoidance routine works, I need to set up an environment where I can ensure this ball is moving at certain speed. So I could answer at what speed of object that this Tello able to be avoided. So for that reason, I'm using this control object speed using pendulum. So this is basic physics. What I'm doing is I'm using this ball and attach a string up to ceiling for 1.5 meters and then tilt it at 30 degrees. And using this formula, potential energy equal to kinetic energy, I would able to find the velocity of this ball at this certain location. So the formula that we need to know is V equal to square root of 2 times G, which is gravity, and also the height. The height here to mention is not the height of the string, but the height between comparison between this one position and this one position. So let's say if I pull the ball up a bit and then release it, so the distance between two position, and using simple trigonometry, I able to find out the height is 0.2 meters. When I put it into this formula, I will estimate at after I release this ball at 30 degrees, this ball at moving at 2 meters per second when reach this location. So let's see how I implement it on actual code using Python. Okay, so here is my state machine. In here, there's plenty of other states. For example, this is the internal one, and this is the public one. So I have start state, exit state, idle state, image process, post process, object track, no object, pass track, obstacle avoidance, altitude control, return home, voice process, and some manual control. The flow is from the image process. From the image process, we will identify the ball speed, distance, and time to collision, right? And then we will identify the TTC is less than 2 seconds or not. For example, so this point here is doing in post-process. In the post-process, I will check if the ball speed, the obstacle TTC is less than obstacle avoidance TTC, which I point here is 2.0 seconds. So if it's true, so then it will enter the obstacle avoidance state machine. So in this obstacle avoidance state machine, I check with the object where it lies, the position, either from the on the right quadrant or the left quadrant. So for example, if the ball is detected on the right quadrant, then Tello should able to move on the side to avoid it. And it will moving at 100% of the speed because of sudden move. And then just capture the last object avoid time. That's it. You can see that this obstacle avoidance is nothing much inside here. It's just to avoid it. Nothing much about to enter back the pass or vice versa is not added yet. But I will show you later how I merge this obstacle avoidance with follow me state. So continue. Here is the SDK that I'm telling you. The SDK here. Now I have two SDK. One is the official one, and the second one is a Tello raw, which means this is sending from the raw UDP packet. You can see some byte buffer here. So when I using this is my main control module, the main one where the state is coming from here. So from here I can easily select either I want to use a drone type mock, which is just for debugging, official Tello app, unofficial Tello app, or let's say if I develop one using PX4. Okay guys, so I wish you guys enjoyed this video. So I hope this opened your imagination on what being possible using this DJI Tello. But if you guys notice, my development work on Python state machine is not being specifically for Tello. It can be used for any one. So the objective for this experiment and some other feature that I have been added is to polish my skill in Python programming, my communication on UDP, and also how I control this such a dynamic object on the air. So by this time, I have added three main features in this Tello. The first one is the follow me tracking mode, which it can follow me everywhere. And second is the path planning, where I can give any maps and point create a path planning waypoints, then it will follow it. And the third one is the obstacle avoidance. So I wish to look into more features to be added in this Tello. So wait for the next video, and till next time, goodbye, thank you.